Yes. A little bit anxious or everything all right?
It's all right.
All right for you? You can begin. You have 10 minutes. We listen to you.
Okay, first, hello everybody. So we were asked to answer the question, how can ArcelorMittal maintain a sustainable business in today's world economic context? My team and I have the pleasure to welcome you at the heart of Chinese households, where we strongly believe that ArcelorMittal will find the solution.
Maybe just one minute. We can have the slideshow, please. Okay, it's good for you now.
Okay,
we can go on with the
okay. First slide. Okay. So as I said, we now go at the heart of Chinese households. So first, the context. Who is Aperam? So Aperam is the stainless steel entity of ArcelorMittal. One of its biggest strengths is its leading R&D capabilities. Aperam has plants in Belgium, in France, and in Brazil. And moreover, Aperam's EBITDA accounts for 5% of the group's gross operating profit. As you might see here on the graph, the Chinese demand for stainless steel is divided into six major segments. And the catering and appliance segment is the biggest one with 34% of the demand. So we think that there is a huge potential there. In 2015, 50% of the global demand for stainless steel in the household appliances segment will be located in China. So we think that ArcelorMittal should be there now in order to enjoy the growth potential of that market. So for us, Chinese footprint would require a strategic alliance. We believe that joint venture would be the key solution. The Chinese market is very fragmented, so there is a high integration potential. Of course, there are many stakeholders that would be involved in such a transaction. The major one, we think, it's the Chinese government. The Chinese government tries at maximum to protect its local companies and its domestic economy, but since it accessed the WTO, we think that there are opportunities for foreign companies to be there. There is also a heavy competition. As I said, the market is very fragmented. But we think that this is an opportunity because there is a high potential of integration in that market. Another point is also the Mittal family. So they are important stakeholders, as the family would like to keep 40% of the shares in any case. So our solution will show you that we can bring satisfaction to all of these stakeholders. We have made market research and we have come to the conclusion that Bahous Steel would be a key partner for ArcelorMittal. First of all, Bahous Steel, this giant Chinese stainless steel producer, has 40% of the domestic market share for household and appliances. This is the second one in China. Another point is that there is already an existing joint venture between ArcelorMittal and Bahous Steel, but for the automotive industry. So this is an opportunity, as the negotiations would be very easier than with another player. We also know that Bahous Steel seeks to improve its product quality in order to become different from its competitors. So for these three reasons and the three others here, which are logistics issues, we know that Bahous Steel has two major plants only dedicated to stainless steels, and these two plants account for 1.1 million of production each of ton of production each year. So these are the reasons, but there are also two points that I would like to tell now. It's that Bahous Steel has a negative gross margin for stainless steel, and we think that this is an opportunity. Why? because we can bring the solution in order for him to control its costs. We know that Chinese producers of steel have a lot of problems to control their costs. And our technology would be a point that would be welcomed by this Chinese player. Another area is, of course, the CO2 issues. But here again, we will show you that we can also bring a solution for the Chinese market. Biomass is the key technology. We have said that ArcelorMittal has leading R&D capabilities. And these R&D capabilities have allowed the group to use bioenergy in the production of steel. And as you can see here on the graph, biomass integration is going to increase until 30% of the production by 2014. So this is a key technology because the use of biomass instead of coke allows the company to produce steel with 33% less of CO2 emission. Moreover, I said that we can help Bahous Steel for managing its cost because, I don't know if you see it, but this graph here shows that the production of 1 ton of steel using charcoal, which is the biomass, allows the company to make 31% reduction in cost instead, of course, of coke. Now, of course, there are costs and revenues. Regarding the costs, we think that 4 major costs should be taken into account. The first cost that would be incurred would be related to human resources. Human resources could be brought by Bahous Steel. Another major cost is linked to intellectual property, but here we know that ArcelorMittal has the key technology, so intellectual property would be brought by Aperam. We also think that there will be important costs linked to the infrastructure and to consultancy. Consultancy would be a very important aspect of the transaction, but we expect it not to be higher than 3% of the total cost. So we think that there will be a need of capital of 2.5 billion euro, and of course the two companies would then have to decide who will bring the major part, or will it be a 50-50%. We know, as I said earlier, that the Mittal family would like to keep 40% in any transaction. So there will be two possibilities for Arcelor to bring the money. The first one is, of course, to borrow money from a bank. We think that it should not be a problem, as Aperam has the implied implicit guarantee of its mother company, ArcelorMittal. There is also another possibility, which is more advantageous, I think, for Aperam. It's to make an intra-group loan. In that case, of course, you will have to pay attention to all transfer pricing issues. So another point here would be to point tax planning issues. So I think that here we have the chance to be able to make a nice tax planification in order to decrease your global tax rate. So for the revenues, we expect the market share to grow between 8-12% per year. So thanks to the differentiation, and as we know, China has an average growth of 10% each year for its economies. We also would like to point the fact that ArcelorMittal should pay attention to the agreement and should be able to decide on the stop or go clause in the case one of the player would leave the joint venture before the end. And in that point, we suggest to begin with the first period of 10 years. And of course, don't forget to secure your IP, because this is what you are going to bring to China. So if the negotiation begin in 2012, we can expect to start the start of the joint venture in 2013. So as I said, ArcelorMittal already knows the company, but still, so negotiation would take maybe between 3 and or 12 months. Between 2016 and 2018, so after 3 to 5 years, you can already expect the return on investment. And after the 10 years, we can maybe expect a high return on equity of 50%, at least between 10 and 50% in the best scenario. Of course, we also want to show why our ID is a good one. We have also CSR policies that support our solution. First of all, we know what are the values of ArcelorMittal. And the first one is making steel more sustainable. And by doing this joint venture there in China, we could bring the solution for Chinese areas in related to CO2 issues. And we will be able to decrease CO2 emission in that area. The other one is, of course, a strong commitment to the workforce. And we will help those Chinese workers to work in safer conditions, and we will offer them trainings in order to make the conditions better than what they are now.
And your last point?
And my last point, of course, is that ArcelorMittal enrich its communities. That's why we have thought about two projects that could be discussed, of course, in order to enrich the Chinese community.
Thank you, Sarah. Thank you very much. I have one. We have only one question of the jury. Who will ask the question in the jury, please? You have a microphone. Here, the microphone is behind you. So, Jacques Pellerin, I think. Yeah, Jacques Pellerin.
So I think it's a very interesting study, a very interesting one. One question: why have you selected chosen China and not India?
I think that if you really want to be the leader in that industry, China is the place to be. Because China has not yet reached the full potential of growth. We know that the growth of stainless steel will still increase by 90%. So the global demand of stainless steel within 5 years will be located by half in China. You have to be there now in order to be able to answer to all this demand. And of course, we know that there are 400 million households in China, and this number is increasing each year. So you will have a high demand, and you have a high profit potential by going there. So this is why we think that China is the place to be for stainless steel.
Thank you, Sarah. Thank you very much to this team. Second team, please.